Alright, you little fucks.
Well, we've all heard the news. DLC 6 has been delayed, the world is burning, Eden 6 is unfortunately still standing, but lo and behold, a new hotfix is upon us, where Gearbox have added the Reiner into Borderlands 3, so it's me, XKenNG, to share with you my top 3 best loot jabber farming locations in order to stay as high as I can in the YouTube algorithm. Yep, that's right, you little fucks. We're loot enemy farming today, and we're gonna be doing my top 3 best locations to farm. So we're gonna be doing my top 3 starting with the worst, and then we're gonna end on what I think is the best, and hopefully you guys get some pretty poggers loot out of this. And if you don't, you should probably dislike the video. For the first location, you're gonna be traveling up to Knotty Peak in the Floodmore Basin, and as soon as you spawn in, the first thing you want to do is run straight ahead, get in the lift and pull the lever, and wait for it to slowly descend. Now when you get down, you just want to head all the way down the little hill, and then you want to take a left into this animal enclosure, where you can find various failed content creators. Oh, look over there, it's Vinylic Puma. I'm kidding, I love Vinylic Puma. Don't try and make drama, I really love him. Yo, I wonder if he's ever going to want to do a top 10 with me after this. Alright, so when you get into this area here, this is where Artemis lives and Apollo. But what's cool about this area is that you can also find loot jabbers. Now, once you find the loot jabbers, which I am not, instead I'm getting my absolutely fucking ass pounced. So, should you get lucky enough and you find a thieving jabber, all you've got to do is first of all catch the little boss, kill the jabber, you might have a chance to get the Reiner. I did not get the Reiner, I got a Maggie. So again, this spot in particular is around somewhere up here near Artemis. It's a pretty good location, I'm not gonna lie. But my issue with it is that you have to take an elevator ride every time you want to get to it. And there's also a bunch of badass jabbers there, which obviously no one wants. But the next spot is pretty damn poggers. So we're gonna head to Ambermire and we're gonna be traveling to the Rogue's Hollow. Now I know what you're thinking, Epic, please don't make me go back to the roguesite place, but it's okay. Hold my hand. It'll be fine. Once you arrive at the roguesite place in Ambermire, all you've got to do is walk down these stairs. It's like the stairway to heaven, but except you're going downstairs and not up them. So here we go. You roll through the moist hoist, and you're just going to keep moving. And then right around here, there's a ton of jabbers. And yeah, that's the farm. There's also a bunch through here as well, which is pretty cool. And if you take a left, you can even go and visit the homie himself, Red Jabber. Look at him. He's... Ah! Oh, and as you can see, we've actually got a thieving jabber right here. So let's see if our luck increases this time, and maybe we'll get the Reiner. And we got a wood blocker, a Lyuda, and Moxie. Okay, you know what? I just give up. So this one, I would actually argue, is the best spot because it's like there's so many jabbers here and you don't have to start a mission like you're going to have to do with the next spot, which, if you don't already know, is the Trial of Instinct. So we're going to have to travel to the Wayward Tether. This is one of the Proving Grounds, aka the Trial of Instinct. And I know your first instinct when you hear the word Proving Grounds is to close the game down and uninstall. But believe me, this one's actually really worth it because it's kind of fast to do. The only reason why I don't like this one is because you have to start the mission to go in, but whatever. So once you get in, all you've really got to do is just play around in this first area, kill a few jabbers to get the thieving ones to spawn in. It's basically a guaranteed rate, but occasionally you can also find some of them spawning under here in the little grotto, which is kind of poggers. But yeah, once you've killed all the jabbers in this first area and you're done with all the thieving ones, all you've literally got to do is just save quit and refarm the first area again. And hopefully when all is said and done, you'll have yourself some pretty poggers loot, including the non-anointed Reiner, because that one fell through the cracks. But there you go, gamers. Alas, Epic has graced you one more time with some infinite wisdom of where you can find the best loot jabbers in Borderlands 3. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy it, feel free to leave a like on it. If you didn't, then I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to engage in some YouTube drama. So make sure you're liking the video and make sure you're subbed to the channel for more poggers content. And on that note, I'll see you in the next one.